Konnichiwa. Today's daily devotional is for Friday, February the 7th, 2020. And it's called, Don't Go Wild, Stay Mild and Watch God Bless You, Child. Okay, I'm gonna start with Genesis 12:3. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonors you, I will curse. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Okay, in 2018, Jeffrey Owens, the guy who played Elvin Thibodeau on The Cosby Show, he was a doctor, and he was also the husband of one of Bill's daughters, the oldest one, Sandra. Okay, he was spotted in 2018, like I said, working at a Trader Joe's as a cashier. All right. So, you know, he played five seasons on The Cosby Show. So the girl that saw him was like, let me get a picture of this. Okay. You would think she was going to do something nice with the picture, but she actually went on Twitter and she was like very upset. So she posted that she was so upset and angry that she wasted 5 years on The Cosby Show watching this guy play a doctor on TV and then in real life become a cashier at a Trader Joe's. Okay? So she was job shaming him, all right? And people were really upset. Like celebrities, they came out and started tweeting about what they did, you know, what they were doing after their career, you know, that was so fabulous, went a bust, you know? So, but they were all actors and they did not want to give up on their, you know, acting career. But in the meantime, they were doing jobs like Mr. Jeffrey Owens, okay? So, he was oblivious to this, the whole thing. He had no idea, maybe for a week or so. And one of his friends tipped him off and said, yo, you're actually famous again, but for the wrong reasons, okay? So he came out of the hiding and he just started talking about it. And then he, you know, replied on social media and said that, you know, he was still doing small acting roles, but they weren't paying at all, like really good. So he had to take on a second job to pay the bills, you know, to supplement his income, you know? Hey, there's nothing wrong with that. I did that as a single mom. I was working at a full-time job and doing Mary Kay full-time. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. Very proud of Elvin, actually Jeffrey, okay? So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna show you a picture, what it says about they were job shaming him, okay? And there he is right there. That's him before and that's him after at the Trader Joe's. You know, it was years later, so he got a little more plumper, you know, and he looks good with his beard. Okay, all right. And there's what she was saying about how she was like devastated, okay? We don't really wanna talk about her. So Elmo, enough, let's move on. Okay, so now I'm gonna go to Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. Well, baby, last week I was watching the haves and the have-nots, the show by Tyler Perry. And who appears on the screen? None other than Mr. Jeffrey Owens himself as a well-dressed politician in a reoccurring role. I was so excited. I was like, look at him looking as sharp as a tack. And I was like, oh my God, yes, Tyler, thank you so much for making Elvin's career pop again after it had fizzled out, okay? And for he may have been a have not for a moment, but now he is a have again, thanks to you, his dear friend. Won't God do it? Okay, so now I'm gonna go to Deuteronomy 24. For the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to give you the victory. Okay, now I'm sure you guys heard about that teenage boy who just recently, a few weeks ago in the news, who he went viral as well. He was asked to cut his dreadlocks off if he wanted to walk across the stage with his classmates to graduate. Okay, they weren't gonna let him march. He can get his diploma, but they weren't gonna let him march. So this guy, you know, he's 15 years old. He stood up for himself, and he said, no, I'm gonna choose to keep my lovely locks, okay? Because they were very well groomed and very well kept, and it was down his back. And he's from Texas, and his name is DeAndre Arnold. Okay, so he said, no, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna watch. I'm gonna keep my lovely dreadlocks. Okay, so he went viral, like I said, with that in the news, and Ellen DeGeneres heard about it. And she offered him a $20,000 scholarship, had him come on her show. And when he got there, she surprised him and let the lovely Alicia Keys, that beautiful songbird, present him with the big giant $20,000 check. He was so excited and shocked, okay? So, and then he got invited to Good Morning America. And Gabrielle Union and her husband, Dwayne Wade, that baller, who also wrote a short film called Hair Love, and it was about loving your hair. So when they saw this, they got with Good Morning America, and because they saw it on Twitter. So they got with Good Morning America, and they set it up. They surprised him on a video and said to him, since they won't let your school won't let you march across their stage, we are going to invite you to have us walk, join us and walk on the red carpet at the Oscars. Oh my God. So him and his mom went crazy because she was there with him. So they ended up paying for their flights, their hotel room, their wardrobe, and also for a glam night. Okay? God is so good. All right. So they paid for all that glamour enough to make you stammer. All right, power thought. When we stand up for what's right, God will put up the fight, so just sit tight. Okay, I can't leave without showing you a picture of Mr. DeAndre. There he is with his lovely self, cute little boy, okay? And there's Alicia Keys giving him the check, all right? And here is also the picture of Gabrielle Union. Okay, love you guys. Have a great day. Mm-hmm.